The car breath tester, still really only in prototype form, it reads out the test for Australia, for example, not Britain, is connected to the car's ignition system. That means a driver has to use the device every time he wants to use his car, whether he's been to the pub or not. The tester works like this. All you do first of all is just turn the ignition key so that the indicator lights come up on the dashboard. Then you blow into your breathalyzer until a beep sounds. Now you then wait until a second beep happens and the readout will tell me whether or not I'm allowed to drive this motor car, for example. And the indicated figure says that I'm 0.011. I can start the engine and drive away. And that's fine. Now, let us assume that I am not in a fit state to drive because I have had too much to drink. And we'll see what then happens. The same procedure is then followed. You turn on the ignition so that the indicator lights come up on the dashboard. Then, purely in the interest of science, you understand, I happen to have with me a small miniature. I'll just take a quick blast of whiskey, all in the interest of duty, you understand. And I will now blow again into the breathalyzer until it bleeps. Yeah. Retest later, I'm over the limit. Now, if I were now with this machine to try to start the car, it would electronically forbid me so to do. But the Department of Transport and the Association of Chief Police Officers urge motorists not to use the device. If they have any doubt about their ability to drive, they shouldn't even think about it, they say. The managing director of the firm selling them thinks they do have a use, though.
The little we've had to do with it, we find it very accurate. I know the police's point of view. If you have a drink, you don't drive. That's in an ideal world. But we are in the real world. People do drink and drive.
They sell for around £300, though they're being sold free here on certain cars. If you want one, though, the full production models aren't yet available. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.